Hello everyone and welcome to the Extreme TIG channel. So for today's video guys, 14 inch skid 80. It's a carbon pipe, got 532 gap one side, the other one I got like loose 1/8, cup size 8 is always pretty much, and tungsten 1/8. So as it's got really three heavy tacks on that pipe, not really worried that it's gonna shrink or something, so I'm gonna just start on this 532 side, usually always on the bottom, sometimes freehand, sometimes walking the cup. In this case I just start walking the cup right away, and back feed technique here with the 1/8 filler wire, ADS D2. It didn't show the part that actually was preheating 300 Fahrenheit. That pipe, it's a welding procedure. And for the root, backfeeding, the rule for me, rule number one, backfeed technique, especially on the bottom part, is I want a heavier root, so I'm not worried for the sag back later. As I said, I got really nice and good solid tacks, not worry about the shrinking. And this is the side that's loose 1/8, it's pretty much the same. And on the side, especially on the side when you're going like from 3 o'clock up to the top, you want to pull it out a little bit outside in the bevel, and just like a constant feed, like 50-50 inside and in and out, and that's how you're going to have nice good solid root. That was the root part. So this pipe is max TIG, gotta be TIG all the way, so it's gonna be lots to fill. There's gonna be lots of passes here, so I'm still for this hot pass. I'm running 160 for the hot pass, 1/8 wire. It's all 1/8 now. It'll be way better if I got 532, but unfortunately they don't have any. So I'm gonna switch to cup size 12. After I did the hot pass, and I'm gonna go up to 180 amps for this one. I'm just gonna start filling sides, one side of the bevel, then the other side. That's how I'm gonna put my passes, and I'm gonna fill all the way to be flush with the pipe. Try to clean each pass. This is one older video I did in the field a couple years back, to show you the way how I'm doing it, especially if it's a max TIG procedure. Just keep it clean, guys. That's most important thing, pretty much, except root part. You want to have nice, good, solid root, lots of meat inside, so you can really run hot, not to be worried about any sag back. So just fill to flush, it's a fill pass game. Put the rod on the top, then you're gonna have a little gap underneath the rod. That's how you know how much steel you gotta fill. Pretty much gotta fill that middle. So I put in the middle, still it's still probably a couple passes left to fill. That's why I said put the rod on the top and that gap underneath. That's how you know how much you gotta fill. So I'm gonna do a couple more passes here until it's gonna be really nice filled to flush. Any uneven spots you can go back and fill it up, do extra pass here and there on the bottom or on the sides, and when it's let it cool down a little bit. It's it works better when it's a little bit cooled off. So I'm gonna put a 3-pass cap, and I switch back to the cup size 10. I'm running 200 amps now for my cap. So the first pass, as I mentioned in my earlier videos before, on any multi-pass joints, you want to make sure that first pass it's maintained straight edge, straight as possible. It's going to look nice at the end, shows your control over that puddle, shows your focus you got as a welder. with the second pass, you always got room for mistakes, as you're gonna cover it on with the third pass. So this is my second pass. I'm overlapping around 50% over that first pass. As I said, clean each pass. You don't want to have any impurities, which is easily collected from the sides of the of that pipe. You know, when the pipe is get hot, and then and you collect all that impurities from the side, which is normal when the pipe is hot, and but it just gets harder to manipulate that puddle. As I said, so the third pass is gonna go here. The less you stop, the better it will look. So this is the opposite side. One side I start on the left side, on the other side I start on the right side. Just the pipe was a little bit oval shaped, so I was kind of compensating with my cap to cover that. Okay, so this is the as the third pass. I'm gonna go 50% over that second pass. As I said, the first and the last pass are two most important passes, as they put a cherry on the top. They can see your control over that puddle. I can see welder's focus, concentration, you know, how focused you are on the welding, and that's what pretty much shows that first straight edge, second and the third one on the pipe side. That's just keep in mind when you're doing any multi-pass joints out there, if you really want to make a difference, and just work on that. Find the amperage that works for you, find the cup size that's going to work for you, you know, amperage, and keep it clean, guys, between passes. That's it, pretty much. And that's it, pretty much, guys, for today's video. I hope you like it. As I said, this is one oldie but goldie. It might help someone in a field. And thanks once again, everyone, for your support. Appreciate all your love and comments. And keep up the good work, guys. And remember, you gotta burn to learn. See you in the next one, guys. Take care.